Sorry, guys, we just dropped that sick intro.
Good morning. Today is Tuesday, January 22nd. I'm Emma.
And I'm Caden.
Our question for today is, what keeps you focused on what you should be... What keeps you focused on what you should be doing when you are at school? Sixth grade silver students, please submit your responses to your advisor, who will post them on Google Hangouts.
Future problem solving will be next Monday, January 28th. That will be your last meet before the regional competition. Good luck. Do you love history? Are you interested in delving deeper into a research of a particular event or person? Consider creating a documentary or a presentation board or enacting a scenario for History Day in Minnesota. The theme for this year is Triumph and Tragedy in History. This opportunity is for 7th and 8th graders only. Please see Ms. Benezra for more information.
Math counts will practice after school on Wednesday, and KMO will be held during lunch for 7th and 8th graders on Thursday. Grab your lunch and come on down to 200.
Our school has a debate club. The first meeting will be held on Wednesday, January 23rd, after school in room 125. There are debate posters with more information and a QR code if you're interested in joining. If there are any questions, please contact Ms. Simpson.
Spirit Week will take place at East the week of February 11th, 15th. We have a ton of fun activities happening, and it should be a great week. Each day, we will have a different theme picked by Trojan Pride Ambassadors. Here are the themes for the days.
Monday, February 11th, is Twin Day. Grab as many friends as you want and dress up like twins, or sport your favorite Minnesota Twins apparel.
Tuesday, February 12th, is Mech Day, a day of comfort, sweats, appropriate PJs, or anything comfy works.
Wednesday, February 13th, is Book Character Day. Crack open a book for some inspiration and come dressed as your favorite character.
Thursday, February 14th, is Throwback Thursday. 80s flashbacks, stirrup, or parachute pants, neon, and leg warmers are welcome.
Friday, February 15th, is School Spirit Day. Show your school spirit by wearing your East apparel or simply dressing in gold and blue.
When deciding what to wear for the theme days, please remember that the dress code still applies. In addition to Spirit Week, we still have some other fun activities during Spirit Week. The TPA will be selling large lip and heart suckers for $1 before school in the cafeteria on Tuesday, February 12th through Friday, February 15th, or till it's sold out.
They will also be selling heartograms for $1, cards with a small candy that allow you to write a special note to a friend. Heartograms will be sold Tuesday and Wednesday morning before school in the cafeteria and will be delivered to students in advisory on Thursday, February 14th, Valentine's Day.
To cap off a great Spirit Week, Winter Carnival will take place from 7 to 9 p.m. in the gym on Friday, February 15th. We will have 3 huge inflatables and pony hops for your entertainment. Concessions will be sold and there will be carnival games. Remember to bring some extra money for spending. If you want to play games and purchase concessions, tickets are $8 in advance and $10 at the door. Buy your tickets before school or during lunch Monday, Friday of Spirit Week.
Remember to show your appreciation to the Trojan Pride ambassadors who make this all possible. You're doing a great job.
Yeah, Caden. Mr. Rice and Officer Carlson will be here after the birthdays for a few words about our dress code. Be sure to stay tuned. And now for the birthdays of the week.
Hey, good morning, East. I'm here with Officer Carlson to talk a little bit about the dress code.
Good morning, everybody.
So just a couple of quick reminders. We've seen a rise in a lot of students wearing their outerwear jackets in the classroom. We're just asking that you please put that in your locker, and you can wear something like this nice pullover Officer Carlson is styling, or perhaps an Argyle sweater or something else to keep warm. I know Caden was wearing a hoodie, so those are all appropriate. We're just asking that your jackets please go in your lockers. We know it's a little bit cool in some rooms, so I'll be working with the custodial staff to make sure the temperature is okay. Another thing Officer Carlson and I are seeing is a lot of students wearing hats and hoods throughout the day. Just a reminder, at 9:10, your hats should be off, and that includes your hats and hoods and any sort of headwear. that we see happening throughout the day. It's mostly hoods and hats. So,
yep, that clarifies it for me. I was going to ask about hats, and you addressed it. Perfect.
Thanks. And the last thing, quickly, is our backpacks. I know it's also winter, and we're putting a lot of things in there, but we're asking that you reduce the size of your backpacks and take only the things you need to class. I notice a lot of kids bringing boots and jackets and things like that in their bags. So please make sure this week we really practice on tidying up your bags and bringing only what you need.
Sounds great.
All right. Thanks, and have a great rest of the quarter here. We got 3 more days till we start the second half of the school year. So have a great week.
Thank you, Mr. Eisen, Officer Carlson. Okay, Caden, what's going on in the news this week?
Hello and welcome to today's current events news bomb thingy. Well, today the government shutdown probably reached day 32, and since our political analysis team isn't very good, and I write this the day before, the shutdown may have quarantined, but let's be honest, it probably didn't stop. There were some threats coming from the Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi, as she threatens to not invite Trump to give the State of the Union address. Trump then took away her private airline flight privileges and leaked her commercial flight data. Ladies and gentlemen, can we give a hand for the most powerful people in America? Recently, Purdue, a large producer of organic chicken nuggets, had to recall many of their products because customers found wood in them. I could see the headlines now. The 100% non-chicken nugget, chicken nugget. Non-GMO, too. Yesterday, there was a super blood wolf moon, a name I did not come up with and would not want to take credit for. The lunar show consisted of a super moon, which happens when the moon is close to the Earth, and a total lunar eclipse. And due to another variety of factors, the moon also looked blood red. That's all for today's current events newsflash thingy.
Thank you, Caden. That was really interesting. Now it's time for the Cottony Act Drawing. Winners have demonstrated East Mode by showing respect for self, others, property, and community. Please pick up your prize in the front office after the show. Let's see who the lucky winners are this week.
Sixth grade winner is... Jalen Riley, caught by Miss Carlson. Congratulations, Jalen.
The seventh grade winner is...
I'm going to say Adatia, caught by Miss
Chaffee.
Miss Chaffee. Apologize if I pronounced her name wrong. Congratulations.
And the eighth grade winner is...
Nathan Morris, caught by Miss Johnson. Congratulations, Nathan.
Eighth graders, try to put more Cottony Act drawings in here. There's barely any. Anyways, congratulations to all of you guys. Let's see what the sixth grade silver students have to say about the question for the week. What keeps you focused on what you should be doing at our school?
Well... James' advisory says wanting to learn / avoid getting sidetracked, stay on task, trying to learn something new, in all caps, not talking during my work, listening to the teacher / staying on task and away from distractions. Susan's advisory says pay attention to the teacher, listen to music while working, and having strict parents. I hope that last one is a good thing.
Okay, here's the joke of the week. You can look for this fox in the media center and submit your joke. Maybe we will choose yours next week.
What do you call an educated tube?
What, Caden?
A graduated cylinder.
Okay.
This joke was made by Pragya, grade 6, Aishita, grade 7, and Josie, grade 6. This was a very early joke submitted, so, thanks, guys, for putting in the joke.
Yeah. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.
Remember, kids, wear your seatbelt.
Buckle it up.